The case would be dropped for one of two reasons, either because the government decided it could not prove the case beyond a reasonable doubt, notwithstanding what evidence it has, or because it decided to grant Smollett what's called a deferred prosecution, which means a short period of probation at the end of which the charges would be dismissed, and he can actually ask for an expungement, which means an eradication of the arrest record. However, from the description Matt Finn gave us, it sounds as if the government has asked to dismiss its own indictment. Quite frankly, this is almost unheard of. It is either the result of extraordinary lawyering on the part of his lawyers or a realization by the government of some defect in its evidence that it did not know it had at the time it sought and obtained an indictment against him.
Okay, 16 counts, right? That's what he was facing. You had these two brothers who were apparently colleagues of his. They worked out together. I think
right.
They worked on the show Empire as well.
Right.
They would, I imagine, those were your two best witnesses, Judge, right?
Yes.
So initially we thought that they brought the evidence and they gave up the goods.
Yes.
Are we to assume that either they didn't have it in the first place or they changed their story?
Well, one of those, Bill, or perhaps the government, doing an investigation after indictment rather than before indictment, discovered something in their backgrounds which would make it impractical or almost impossible to put them on a witness stand. Now, the 16-count indictment was really overkill. It basically was one charge for every time Jussie Smollett spoke to the cops, even though he basically said the same thing each time he spoke to him. They spoke to them. So it should have been a one-count indictment. Instead, they did 16. Why? Because the police were furious that they had been played, in their view, and used by Jussie Smollett. We may get a different story now when his lawyers come to those microphones.
Okay, so here's the story we thought we knew. Reading from the AP story now, police and prosecutors have said the black and gay actor falsely reported to authorities that he was attacked on January 29 downtown Chicago because he was unhappy with his pay on the Fox show and to promote his own career. So what happened since the 29th of January when they put that story together and today?
They
don't know.
Well, we'll find out soon, and it's one of two events, in my view. They either discovered some impediment to the presentation of this case, something in the background of the witnesses that would make them not credible before a jury, or they decided to grant him this once-in-a-lifetime deal, which almost everybody gets in the United States when the crime is not one of violence, not one of distribution of drugs, and not part of an organized criminal enterprise, which is a deferred prosecution. This is the same type of deal that was offered to Bob Kraft in Florida, which he rejected because in Florida they required an admission of guilt. If this is a deferred prosecution, which will result in the dismissal of the charges, in Chicago it does not require an admission of guilt.
Okay, you just said a moment ago that this almost never happens for prosecutors. Which aspect of that, Judge?
The dropping of their own case within a month of indictment because they discovered a defect in the case. If that is what happened, that's very poor policing on the part of the prosecutors because they should have known of that defect before they sought his indictment.
All right, Judge, hang on one moment. Sandra's got the statement again from his attorneys.
Here's Smollett's attorneys issuing this statement about the hearing, after the hearing, I should say. Today, all criminal charges against Jussie Smollett were dropped and his record has been wiped clean of the filing of this tragic complaint against him. Jussie was attacked by two people he was unable to identify on January 29th. He was a victim who was vilified and made to appear as a perpetrator as a result of false and inappropriate remarks made to the public, causing an inappropriate rush to judgment. Jussie and many others were hurt by these unfair and unwarranted actions. This entire situation is a reminder that there should never be an attempt to prove a case in the court of public opinion. That is wrong. It is a reminder that a victim, in this case Jussie, deserves dignity and respect. Dismissal of charges against the victim in this case was the only just result. Jussie is relieved to have this situation behind him and is very much looking forward to getting back to focusing on his family, friends, and career.